Hey guys, so today is gonna be the part two of the legacy of Mike Tyson. This is gonna be the part two of the whole thing, and yeah, I made part one, and I don't know. That's like since I made it, I've just been excited about like making more videos. I also made another video on Joe Frazier, but yeah, I don't know, man. I'm getting excited about YouTube. I feel like I don't know. I have something. I don't know, man. But yeah, today we're gonna do the legacy of Mike Tyson part two. In the last video, I think we did the first half of his career, and I think this second half is gonna be like his downfall.
The debt is paid. The prison term over. 3 years ago tomorrow, Mike Tyson entered an Indiana penitentiary, having been convicted of rape and deviant sexual misconduct. On this day of his exit, the people around him were the same as ever. But something inside Tyson may have changed.
Once he came out of prison, Tyson was he kind of lost his head movement, but he was as intimidating as ever. The baddest man on the planet. There was no one like him. He had his power. His power increased, if anything. There's no one like me. Lennox. No, I'm not. My defense is impregnable. I want your heart. Praise to Allah. Different. That's like a legendary quote. Now, Bruno. The thing when I saw Mike beat Bruno, I was actually surprised. Because Bruno is huge. If you actually look at Bruno in his prime, he's actually huge. Like, he's just a hunk of muscle. I thought Mike was going to lose. And let's be honest, even though I love Mike, he was losing till he won. He was losing the whole, his head movement. I think Bruno even caught him. I wobbled him. That was the first time I ever seen Mike get wobbled. But the power was still there, man. You couldn't play around. That uppercut was too deadly. Oh, no. Oh, slimy piece of shit. Dumb. King. Who do you know goes to prison, comes back, and wins a championship? Wins two of them. He won two of them. Unified two. Mike never lost that power. The power just kept increasing and increasing and increasing. Look at this. That's a perfect punch right there. 1-2, right on the button. But he was not the same Mike. I'm just being honest. He was a different Mike. No head movement. His power increased, intimidation increased. So most of the time, he beat his opponents before he even got in the ring. And let's not talk about the headbutts. Right there is a low blow. That's a low blow right there. Let's be honest. Let's not talk about the headbutts. Exactly. Like, bro, like, this is not coincidental. The band of only feel is good for these two. Golly, look at that. He has a demon back. And I think about Mike, he never gave up, even though he was weak. He just kept on going. If I was Mike Tyson, I would have been scared too. Okay. Look at the drop of his leg, the foot. Just perfect play. Oh, damn. same. They ruined the prison.
It's a different cake we
want
tonight.
It's just you know, heavy. You see, Mike in 1987. He's not eating punches like this. He's moving his head, slipping every punch. I want to say, it doesn't matter, he wasn't at his prime. Like, look at this.
Mike Tyson weighs in at 218 pounds.
Yes, Tyson, 15 stone, 8 pounds.
Fun fact, Mike Tyson was at his best when he was around 210, no, actually 215. That was when he was in his real, like, prime.
It's the lightest he's been since his release from jail. We'd heard he'd driven himself into great shape. Here was the proof. Yes, Tyson, 15 stone, 8 pounds. The lightest he's been since his release from jail. We'd heard he'd driven himself into great shape. Here was the proof.
218 pounds, the same weight for the champion, Evander the Real Deal Holyfield.
The ever serene Holyfield, exactly the same weight.
I think at this time, Mike was just fighting for the money, to be honest. I feel like it just was not in him anymore. At this point in time, he wasn't, like, mentally, like, boxing-wise, he wasn't there. But mentally, he really, like, he was already far from boxing. And like Cus said, and I said before, boxing is 75% mental and 25% physical. So he just wasn't the same.
His heaviest ever, he says he's gone for extra leg strength and power. This was the last time they'll be together before they meet again in the ring. There's no doubt that Tyson, despite all he's achieved, has to prove here that he's not yesterday's man. But at least his fan club are in no doubt about the outcome.
This is a fateful day. The fateful day.
Tyson in five. Tyson in five.
There's another guy here. What do you think?
Tyson in seven.
Is anybody a Holyfield fan?
Another thing. Evander Holyfield is not scared of Tyson.
Tyson's going to knock him out in the third round.
One up on him.
He's a great champ. Richard J. Kelly's done a great job, and Tyson's going to knock him out.
I'm looking forward to knocking him out. My theory is to destroy or be destroyed, and that's just... I love that with Terry and I love that with Hot Life.
This is a unique, rare, and wonderful mixture of sports and emotion and passion that is going to be flowing that evening, excitement and the pumping of your heart. The adrenaline is flowing. The momentum is so large you can cut it with a knife, and it's growing by geometric progression. So the excitement is in the air. It is a contagion.
One punch knockout type guy. He was headhunting for that. No more body punches, just straight to the head. No more combos, no more blistering speed. He just was not the same person. Headbutt again, headbutt.
That's just what happened, and Mike said, what about this fighting? What about this head?
I feel like the ref did a shit job.
Deja vu. Look at the blood streaking down from the outer portions of the...
Try to lift it. That's how you know Evander Holyfield is. He tried the leaping left hook right there, but Evander Holyfield took a step back.
Look at the blood streaking down.
Another thing is, at this point in time, people already knew Mike's move, so... I feel like something like that, that's something you do after setting up the trap of hitting the body multiple times. So when you bait like you're going down for the body, he puts his hand down and just takes him off his feet. Ref didn't do nothing.
Tyson comes out first but forgot his mouthpiece.
He's anxious to get this on. I think he's blown the first two rounds.
Okay. And he better get started. Nice slip.
Round two, very bad for Tyson with that bad cut. First to win by Holyfield. Again, showing his strength.
Before he would move his head before every punch and after every punch. He's just headhunting.
Bless him.
He was never a 1-2 type of fighter. He was a... nice low blow again. If you really take this into perspective, was this fair? Let's be honest, was this fair? I'm not dick riding Michael or anything, you know what I'm saying? Pause. But like, was this fair?
Back comes Tyson. on the belt. Tyson with a short left hook to the head of Holyfield.
Oh yeah, that's the part about this.
What happened here?
He's
joking. He got bit, I think. Evander Holyfield, look out!
And apparently Holyfield gets steroids too.
Tyson.
And that was the thing why he's so big.
Oh my goodness, he's got a bloody right ear. Holyfield bit by a dirty.
You know, the first time when I heard Mike Tyson bit Evander Holyfield, I thought it was once. It wasn't until I actually did my research and watched the videos. Mike Tyson is he's actually an animal. He's a beast. He bit him twice. Twice, no remorse.
Well, first he had a parachute drop on him, now he
still
had a heavyweight
behind him. No, yeah, he's like, yeah, what's up? He's like, yeah, what you gonna do? He's like, yeah, yeah, what you trying to get into? What you gonna do about it?
Oh, here comes the commissioner now. They gotta figure it out.
This is where Michael Drew is. Mike can never get caught with those type of punches in his prime. He's moving, see, he just came straight at him. Straight at him. He still had his stance switching. How he moves, changes the southpaw with the right hand.
Let's
get him again. He said, come on, bring it, let's go. You're headbutting me, let's go, low blows. Let's go, come on. You're headbutting me, I still continue fighting. He said, what's up? So let's go. Yeah, that's sick. That right there is cool. He said, come on. Come on. Look at the crowd. Now look at the crowd. Look at the crowd. The crowd's like, what's going on? That dude is on feet. He's still on top.
Headbutt Mike for two fights. Headbutt is a foul, a complete foul, but it's been happening so often, so long,
Mike was with
that when a person headbutts another person, puffs both of their eyes, it becomes a common thing, and it's okay to let that go. Oh, Evander got a little nip on his ear that don't...
Little,
he jumped around like a little bitch.
One is accidental, and it appears
no,
to
be... One headbutt may be accidental, 15 is nine. Well, two fights. Mike done been caught four times by this guy, neither time by a punch.
You had a chance to fight. You know, why you got a bite on my ear?
Regardless of what I did, he headbutted me for two fights.
Why did you do that, though, Mike? I mean, was
look
that the proper
me.
Response?
Look at me. I got to go home. Yeah. My kids are going to be scared of me. Look at me, man.
What are you going to do now? Hold your career, Mike.
Let me
look at me. I got to go home. My kids are going to be scared of me. Look at me, man.
What are you going to do now? Hold your career, Mike. What are you going to do?
That must hurt, too. That's another thing about boxing. They don't show pain. Lennox Lewis. Like, I don't know, like, people saw this happening, like, they didn't do nothing. They saw him spiraling out of his life. Like, you could easily tell by just looking at him that Mike was not himself. He was scared. Mike was scared. He was scared of the vultures around him. He was scared of the people around him. He couldn't trust no one. Pause.
Bitch, come on, bitch. You're scared, coward. You got man enough to fuck with me. You can't last 2 minutes in my world, bitch.
This is a man.
You're scared now.
This is a man who can't trust nobody. He's lost. Doesn't know who to be with. Has a lot of people around him, but is really alone. That's why he lashes out at everything. He's protecting himself. That's a defense mechanism.
It's because I'm not a corporate man, so to speak. I didn't fit in with society standards. I just have to reign. I have to reign.
Lennox Lewis.
Tyrannical. I have to be the beast. I have to be the
Lennox
savage.
Lewis beat him fair and square. That one,
I cannot society that believes that I'm trash and I'm
deny.
Scum. I'll be trash and I'll be scum, but I'll be angelic trash and scum.
Here is the youngest man.
Even though he was already passes. If Evander and Lennox fought him 1989, 1988, Mike would have destroyed them. Because at the same time, like here, right here, Lennox is in his prime. Lewis is in his prime. But Mike is not. You know what I'm saying? prime versus prime, I still pick Mike.
Ladies and gentlemen,
because Lennox knows how to control distance, but when Mike is cutting distance, cutting angles with his head movement, coming under, going low and tank hitting high. Lennox knew how to catch him. No head movements. Not at all.
Tyson had the stronger jaw. He has certainly shown a strong jaw in this fight because he has
getting caught with that jab too much.
So far.
Hands guarding on his chin. Elbows not tough. You see how he changed? Before, Michael never guard like that. Michael never guard. He would never do a high guard. The guard would always be on his chin. No head movement, like that's 6 punches. Just hit. 6 punches hit just like that. And he's just headhunting. Oh my god. It sucks to see this. It's just tragic. It sucks. It sucks. Like it's sad. It's sad. It can make a grown man cry. It's sad to see a man fall. But it's great to see a man get up when he falls. There's no better redemption than getting up when you fall. And Mike did just that. From the bottom of the pit to the tip of the skyscraper, and back to the bottom of the pit, and brought himself back up. That's a true success story. Control his ball. Perfect punches. Sucks, bro.
Mike Tyson has arrived at a Phoenix hospital where his 4-year-old daughter is on life support following what police are calling a tragic accident.
His legs helped me, you know. And then when I got there and I saw other people's children were dying too.
R.I.P.
And so I didn't have any right to go up there like I was a hell of a motherfucker. I'm badass. I'm a raise hell when other people have people that they loved and cared about just as much as I did. And they were dying too. They were dead already. So who was I going to be up there to talk to raise hell like I was somebody? So I had to have that loss.
That's just facts. That's just real shit. So I think the video's done. Yeah, the video's done. So, yeah, man, that's just the legacy of Mike. This is the end of his, not the end of his career, but the end of his boxing career, you know what I'm saying? And I think his last fight, he lost to Kevin McBride. And before that, he lost to Daniel Williams, if I'm not mistaken. But like in the Kevin McBride video, fight at the end, that was when he retired. He said he didn't have it anymore, you know what I'm saying? He could be in shape, it just didn't have the ferocity, the will, you know, the mentality. He lost it. That warrior's mentality was not there anymore. He was just doing it for the money. And yeah, only a man could admit to that. Could say, yeah, you know what I'm saying? I'm not good anymore. You know, only a man, a real man. But yeah. From Kid Dynamite to Iron Mike, and then the Vultures came in, Robin Givens, Don King, Cuss died, Jim Jacobs died, Bill Clinton, you know, all of his fired, Kevin Rooney, all the main people around him, he was just manipulated to just take them away, you know, and, you know, it sucks. And then going to prison for conviction of rape. I don't know about the rape thing. You know, it was just a he said, she said type thing. And it was only two of them who saw. So the
naturally, they'll always pick the woman's side. And I'm pretty sure in the case, there was like a witness who saw both of them going into the hotel, but she wasn't allowed to testify in court. Kind of fishy, if you ask me. But, you know, I wasn't there, so I wouldn't know. Because, you know, it just sucks. It sucks to see a man get destroyed by others and get destroyed by himself. Let's not even talk about the drug abuse, alcohol, the cocaine that he did. You know, just sucks, man. But like I said, it's the end of the video. And, you know, I'm actually excited about this YouTube journey, for real. Like, I don't know. I'm gonna keep uploading and just seeing what happens, sees what happens, you know. I hope y'all enjoy. Subscribe, like, and comment. Thanks.